Are you having a geographic tongue, or you are just curious about a geographic tongue? Well, you just clicked on the right video. In this video, we are going to learn what a geographic tongue is and why it is called a geographic tongue. The other names of a geographic tongue, the causes of a geographic tongue, the signs and symptoms of a geographic tongue, the treatment of a geographic tongue, and finally, at the end of this video, I'm going to give my personal recommendation and my tip that works well in the management of a geographic tongue. Make sure that you stay with me until the end. So let's dive right in. My name is Dr. Emmanuel Amukun from Marvel's Dental Hospital. So what is a geographic tongue? Well, a geographic tongue is a harmless condition that affects the surface of the tongue, commonly putting patches that keep on moving from one position to another. So why is it called a geographic tongue? This is simply because the borders of the patches tend to resemble the geographic borders of the maps of the globe. And this geographic tongue also has other names. One of the names is erythema migrans. This is a medical word that, when translated in English, simply means a migrating red patch. Erythema means reddish. So when you say erythema migrans, that means a migrating red patch because of the tendency of this patch to keep on shifting from one position to another. And that is also the same reason why it is called a wandering patch. Not that it actually moves. What happens is that in that position where it is, that part heals and then another patch develops in another side of the tongue. So it seems to look like it is shifting from position to position. And the actual medical name is benign migratory glossitis. As you have already heard, migratory, that means shifting from one position to another. Glossitis refers to the tongue, and then benign, translated into English, basically means harmless. But also, there are times when it is used to refer to something that is not cancerous. The opposite of cancerous is benign. But in this particular case, it refers to harmless or something that is not posing a serious threat to health. So basically, when we say benign migratory glossitis, we are simply saying a harmless migrating patch of the tongue. So those are the three names of a geographic tongue. So how does this patch come about? Usually, a normal tongue is covered with bumps. Think of them more like goosebumps of the tongue. But unlike the other goosebumps, these ones are permanent. And these bumps are divided into two types, the red and the white. So normally, it is the white bumps that get wiped out. So when they become wiped out, it exposes more the red ones. And that's why the patch looks reddish in color, even though there are few cases where it might actually look white. In that case, it means the red ones are the ones that got wiped out and will remain with the white ones. So the patch appears white, but commonly it is red. What are the signs and symptoms of a geographic tongue? Well, we have already mentioned the first one, the red migrating patch. That is actually the most reliable sign of a geographic tongue. As for the symptoms, for a majority of people, the geographic tongue does not pose any symptoms. However, a small section of people have reported a burning sensation associated with eating salty or spiced foods. And in a few cases, it can translate into pain, but these are much, much lower in number. So what causes this geographic tongue? Truthfully, the actual cause is still unknown. However, there are a few conditions that they have tried to link to the development of this geographic tongue. And these are emotional stress, psychological factors, diabetes, allergies, habits, hormonal disturbances, and association with blood group O. However, there is no conclusive evidence that links a geographic tongue to any of those that I have mentioned. So the cause is still unknown. If you are getting any value from this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't yet subscribed, please make sure that you hit that red subscribe button right now and we continue. Thank you for doing that. So what is the treatment for this geographic tongue? Well, there is no treatment. Because a geographic tongue, in the real sense, is not an actual disease. Remember, we have already said it is harmless. And then the other thing is that it is self-limiting. It heals itself and then shifts to another position. And then at one point, all the patches will disappear and you don't have any. And again later, they may reappear. So there is no treatment for this geographic tongue. But what we can do is to relieve the symptoms. If you are feeling that burning sensation when you take salty or spicy food, then that's what we need to alleviate. And the most important thing is to identify what actually worsens that burning sensation or the discomfort, and then avoid it. So that's your treatment number one. But in other cases, we may need to apply some surface, what we call topical solutions. And one of them is to give you a high dose of vitamin, usually vitamin B6, vitamin B12, and folate. In addition to that, we could also give you some topical anti-inflammatory agents just to put on the surface. That should be able to relieve the symptoms. But the most important thing to remember as regards this treatment is this. This geographic tongue can actually resemble other lesions of the tongue, which are indicative of a more serious illness or of an illness elsewhere in the body. So proper diagnosis of this is very, very important. So whenever you have patches on your tongue, make sure that you visit your dentist and have it properly diagnosed. If it is a true geographic tongue, then the management is very, very simple. But don't assume, because you might assume when it is something more serious. Finally, my personal tip and recommendation for managing a geographic tongue. Well, in my practice, I have found that this actually works, not as treatment, but it alleviates the symptoms quite easily. If a patient comes with this burning sensation and they cannot eat anything, I would recommend you take something like benzocaine lozenges, because this is a topical anesthetic. So it is going to provide temporary numbing of the tongue so you can be able to eat your food until the patch disappears and then you resume your normal life. That's all you need to know about the geographic tongue. And if you like this video, you might want to check out this playlist here or this other video here. And I'll see you in the next one.